Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. This is going to be a quick video. It's not going to be something long, at least I don't think. So recently I did get a comment on asking on how I set up my Notion, how I use Notion and stuff like that. And Notion is honestly my best friend. Like, I love Notion. It's one of my favorite things. Or I guess note-taking, keeping track of things, progression and stuff like that. It's one of my favorite programs to use. So Notion is free. They do have a paid plan that I think is more so for businesses, but if you're just using it by yourself and you just want to use it to keep track of things, whether it be for school, work, budgeting, gaming, etc., then Notion is the perfect thing. Trust me, I am not sponsored. I literally just love Notion so much. So typically what I use Notion for is I use it to track my projects. So I do write on my free time, so I track my book projects and ideas and stuff like that, as well as I use Notion for keeping track of my gaming and my YouTube. So in this case, what you are seeing right now is my Notion for my Swords Only gameplay. So I use Notion to keep track of when I've done my dailies, as in commissions, expeditions, resin, condensed resin, use all of that, weeklies as well as keeping my long-term goals, so 100%ing each region, etc., a to-do list, and I have days rotations where I write down or put down each and every like little thing that at least relates to my character and stuff like that, and the weapons that they use. I keep track of, you know, who needs what on what day and stuff like that. So for example, each thing has a day on what day they're available. So day rotations, this is for everything. So if I wanted today, so for example, today is Saturday, so I would click Saturday and it would show me everything that is available for Saturday. So as of today, I could farm for Sack Sword, I could farm for Nilu, I could farm the Iron Sting, and I could farm the Skyrider Sword. My Notion also includes a timeline. So what the timeline is that it just shows you all of the events and all of the banners and stuff that are happening in Genshin at the moment. So you can kind of keep track. So let's say I haven't logged into Genshin in like a week and there's an event going on and I don't know when that event ends. I don't have to go all the way into my game to figure out how many days are left. I can just look at this timeline, the live calendar, and see when the event is about to end or when it ends, etc. I also keep my characters for who are going to be on my main team, so if I were to click on one of them, whether I click here or I click here, it will take me to a page where I have for each and every character, I have what element they are, what their role is, if their build is in progress. I also keep track of all of their materials and stuff like that, so I can see how many materials that I have of each item. So that goes for their chunks and slivers and fragments, their local specialty, their world boss materials, as well as their mob boss materials. And then the same goes for their talents. And then below that is, again, what their build is going to be and what artifact sets that they're going to need, what is their prioritized skill. So skill burst normal attack for Nilu, what they need for their artifact stats, what their substats should be, and the materials for their weapons, as well as some references that I can look back on. So I do this for every Genshin account that I have. So this isn't just something that, you know, I just do for this one particular account. It's for every Genshin account that I have. If you want to take a look at what my other ones look like, this one in particular is for my Ganyu account. So as you can see, I've done everything for Mondstadt and now we're working on Liyue. This is before I kind of got more comfortable with setting up my thing. So a lot of my newer little Notion things look different from this one, just because I did make some changes, but it still is the same of keeping track of what to do on what day, what my team is, what the builds are, and this is a database. This one has more characters, obviously, because I've had this account longer, but it's a database. I keep track of all characters, when those characters were gained, etc., who I focused on, how many their ascension levels are, how many constellations, what level they are, everything. I just started doing this where I put in their star levels so I can see if they're 4-star or 5-star. But that kind of is unnecessary. But that's what I like to do. I really enjoy doing this. It keeps it all together and it looks neat. It looks satisfying. I also use Notion for YouTube. So this is what my YouTube one looks like. It's kind of just there. It's not really necessarily, it's like kind of messy, but kind of together at the same time. So as you can see, which I probably will end up blurring around just because it does have some personal stuff on here. It is my YouTube schedule. So basically I will describe what's on the schedule. So it'll be what day I record or what day this video goes out or what I do on this day, all that other stuff. Again, there are some personal things on this particular calendar, so it's probably going to be blurred out in post editing, which I definitely will, because again, personal stuff, I don't really want to put too much of my personal life out there on YouTube, etc. And then if I click on, let's say, Genshin New Rolling until I get a 5-star, it will take me to the page that I have where it's my Genshin Rerolling until I get a 5-star. So the same thing, I don't want to scroll down any further just because there are some passwords at the bottom. So, but it's essentially the same thing as every single Genshin Notion that I always use for everything. The only two accounts that don't have Notions are obviously my two mains, because I didn't start doing this until probably earlier this year. I just decided I wanted somewhere to keep track of all of my stuff and all that other good stuff. And so obviously you probably came here to see how I set everything up. So let's go ahead and do that. So here we are. I will link this template below. This is a template that I made myself. I pretty much had to do, again, I did all of this by myself. This is all stuff that I've just kind of, I got ideas from other people, but I ended up like putting all of this together myself, having to figure out how to link everything all by myself and stuff like that. So, which I've said 10 times already that I did this by myself. So obviously you would take this away. So as you can see, it's my Genshin account template. This is the template that I use for all of my Genshin accounts. So to start off, let's start with up here. So here is where I would put my UID for the Genshin account that I am on. So it'll be different depending on if you're on the American server, on the Asia server, or the European server, etc. What adventure rank I am, what my world level is, and then I would also, again, put what server that I'm on. So in this case, it just says NA server. This is just stuff that you fill in as you go. To scroll on to dailies, so this button is set. So let's say you did your commissions today, you did your expeditions today, you used your resin, and you didn't do these two other things, but now it's a new day. What you would do is you would take all of this, highlight that, I put it in archive so I don't have to see it, then this button is set to renew my dailies, and I can do it all over again for the next day. Same thing goes for renew weeklies. So let's say I fought Azdaha today, I did Dvalin, and I used the paramedic transformer, and I did my bounties today. Now this is weekly stuff, so I wouldn't renew this until after the new week starts, since this is all stuff that doesn't reset until after the end of the new week, or the beginning of the new week, which I believe would be Sunday, if I'm not mistaken. So say it's a new week, I would take all of this, put it in archive, renew weeklies, and now my stuff is fresh for the week. Long term, obviously, is stuff that is long term, so I would check off everything as I go. So let's say I found all the Seelies, found all the shrines, max my Mondstadt reputation, found all the Animoculuses, etc. This is just an example. I tried to make sure I got everything for each region. There may be some stuff I'm missing out on, because trust me, after Liyue, I am completely in the dark about what exactly I need to do or what is in each region, but I just did some googling to try and find out as much as I can. So for example, there is the fountain for Fontaine that is not on here, so it would be, you know, I would add on here max out Fontaine fountain, because basically in Fontaine, the tree that like Sumeru and Inazuma have is actually a fountain in Fontaine. So then I would just hide all this, and I would only unhide it when I'm on that region. So let's say I'm done with Mondstadt, then I would unhide Liyue, finish Liyue, and I'm now on Inazuma. Next up, we have our day rotations. So as I said before, this is for you know, you keep up with what thing is available on what day. So what stuff is available on Mondays, Thursdays, Sundays, what stuff's available on Tuesday, Friday, Sundays, what stuff is available on Wednesday, Saturdays, and Sundays. So here I would mainly put everything here just so then it's a lot easier instead of just being like, okay, let's put something here. Like, I want to see everything as it is. I should also mention a to-do. This would just be, I put stuff that I would like to focus on my account and stuff like that. So let's just say that's today, it would be finish filming Notion video that you're watching now. Then we have our timeline, and then at the bottom we have our main team, our character roster, and our master character directory. Now you're probably asking how I actually get together each page for each character. It sounds like a tedious long process, but honestly it is something I actually really enjoy. It's quite satisfying to look at, so let's go ahead and get started. So this is the character build page template. As you can see, it's a template. I will also link it. I will link both my main page template for Genshin as well as my character build page for template as well in the description below. So what you see on here is again the element, the role, what their status is in terms of build. You'll see what element they are, what friendship level they are, and what level they are. Under to do will be farm, you know, whatever thing I need to work on. So let's say I need to farm local specialties, I will put what their local specialty I need to farm is here. I like to level up my characters to level 80. You can change this if you want to. So you put your local specialty here, the sliver, the fragments, the chunks, the world boss, and the mob enemy drops. Mind you, it is very, you need to keep track of this. It's not updated on this one, but it is on my actual main Genshin ones. Make sure that you keep track of materials for both the talents and your character. So what I would do is I would put plus talent, because whenever you are, I don't think I would for this one, but I would for this one right here. So I would put plus talent now because I need to keep track of materials for both their talents and the actual character themselves, because they both use the same materials. So if I'm not mistaken, I believe this is actually 36. This is 96, I think. I could be wrong. And then this is going to be the same number as up here because this is including the talent and the character. And I think that's 96, and if you want, you can change this to say plus character. And then below that, obviously, I will put whatever my artifact set is. This is something a little bit more kind of, this may or may not be out of your comfort zone, but to work this out, let's say I want to change this to support. So I would take this away. I would put support and I would just click done. So now it says support. If it's something that has a space, for example, so where it says, where it said main DPS before, I would put main DPS space. I think this is backspace, space again, and then DPS, and then click done. And then now that that is changed, obviously below is where the artifacts go, and below that is where their weapon materials go, and I would keep track of the weapons materials. So now let's actually fill in this page ourselves. I decided to use Albedo for this example just because everyone knows I love Albedo. He is one of my favorite characters. So let's just say you are just now wanting to start this, you're just got a new 5-star, and you know, that 5-star being Albedo, and you want to actually start getting a page together. It doesn't matter where you are in terms of your account, but let's just say you kind of just started out, Albedo just had a rerun, and you just got Albedo. You haven't kept track of all the other characters, but now you see this and now you decided that you wanted to do it. So why don't we go ahead and fill in Albedo? So what I do, obviously, change this to say Albedo, his element Geo. I believe Albedo's best role is a sub DPS or a support. Now, if you're not too sure what role you would like to choose for your character, there is a site that I use that is called Game 8. It is where I go to look at a lot of builds for my characters. I also go to Ziox on YouTube, which I will link him in the description below, just because he's amazing at doing character builds and stuff like that. I really like to use his content, but I've been using Game 8 more. So, this is what Game 8 looks like. I've already Googled Albedo and pulled up his build. You can do it for any character. So let's say you wanted to do Sayu build. It would immediately take you over to Sayu's build, tell you what roles that she can have. So she can be a swole driver, crit sub DPS, or a healer support for C6 and before C6, you know, etc. And it tells you all of the materials, weapons, artifacts, and stuff that are the best for every single character. So let's go back to Albedo. So in this case, it looks like Albedo can be a sub DPS. He can be mostly a Geo sub DPS. So I would take this information and I would input it on my Notion. So sub DPS, take that out. Status, I would change to build in progress. Then I would take this, fill in Geo. Press the, if you are on a Windows computer, you would just press the Windows key and period. This will bring up a emoji thing. I would probably type in Brock for Geo. Put that right here just because I like that. That's just some personal thing. We just got Albedo, so he would be level 1. So the next step for this is, I just started doing this recently, I would actually calculate how much stuff I would need myself based off of what Game 8 has told me, but sometimes their website won't be, it'll kind of be a little messy from time to time, just because there have been times where I had characters that I needed their stuff and it said this material, but it wasn't the correct material in the game. So I now use the Genshin Enhancement Calculator. Genshin Enhancement Progression Calculator is the full term. Is basically, it tells you, or you add in a character that you would like to build. So in this case, we are going to do Albedo. Enter. Click Albedo. Now, this tells you everything that they need in terms of local specialties, how much hero weight it's going to take, how much Mora, how much mob boss materials it's going to take, etc. Again, for me, as you know, I like my characters to be up to level 80 unless I say otherwise. Talents, I'm not going to worry too much about, just because it's, I don't necessarily know the level that I need for, like, what level it is for the talents that I've got up here. So this is how much I may need, but I'm not too sure what level that is, so I won't touch that and I'll keep that as is. But for 80, this is how much stuff we're gonna need. So this, again, there's our talents, all that other good stuff. So I would take this information right here and I would copy that into here. So Albedo's local specialty is Cecilia's. Did I spell that right? Well, it's a name, that's why. Then, obviously, we have our Sliver. So his is actually the Prativa Topaz Sliver. So I kind of just, you know, I cut corners, you know, since it's not going to make that big a difference. So I would just put Topaz Sliver. And I would do the same here. Topaz Fragment, and then Topaz Chunk, then his World Boss. I don't put the World Boss, I put the World Boss material, obviously. So then this would be, in this case, the Basalt Pillar. If you do scroll over to the side, you press this right here, or click that and scroll over to the side. Now, these are just old notes that I should probably get rid of, because this is probably for another character. And you can make little notes on the side for where this material comes from. So, for example, the Basalt Pillar, are we on the right one? 26, so this gets up to 80. So, for example, the Basalt Pillar would be, comes from the Geo Hypo Status. So I know where I can get this from. Or the Cecilix, for example, found on Star, I think it's Star Snatch Cliff. I think that's what it's called. So I could put that to be like, to know that I need to look in that general area for this. So the mom enemy. Don't remove this. Remember, this is adding in the talents as well, because you are going to need the same materials for your talent and your character. In this case, he needs the divining scroll. So this is the I think 1-star materials. Then I would go back, look, then the 2-star materials, I put diving scroll, divining scroll. Then this would be the 2-star materials. So this is going to be the, let's say, sealed scroll. Yes, sealed scroll. Since this is only up to level 80, I'm not too sure, again, what is needed for anything here. Like, this is how much I have here. I could very well be wrong. That might change at some point. But last would be the forbidden. Oh, I cannot spell today. Forbidden curse skull. Did I spell that right? I did. So now we have all of our materials needed for actually ascending the character up to level 80. This can change depending on how you, if you decide to do level 90. So you may need to add in a new thing. So let's just say there is an extra material now. Let's just say obviously a character is not going to have a local specialty, but let's just say, oh yes, actually, let's just do one of these. So you have your slivers, your fragments, your chunks, and then you have your, what is it? Let's do up to 90, because that gives you the final kind of form of that one. The gemstone. So let's just say you wanted to take your character to level 90 and you know, this is not available, you know, you're just up to sliver, fragment, chunk, because obviously I don't level my characters to 90. You would just click new here at the bottom. Then you would just put in topaz, gemstone, insert a 0. Then let's see how many we need. We need 6. You put 6 here. If you want to move it, just click this right here where it says drag to move. Drag that up here. Put that underneath chunk. And there you go. Now all of that is in perfect neat order, in order of how it needs to be collected. On the side as well, where it says progress, whenever you put something in, so this is the total amount needed, and obviously this is how many we collected so far. So let's just say we collected 44 Cecilia so far. I would put 44. This will move up depending on that percentage. I am 41% away from collecting the total amount of local specialties that we need. So now that that's out of the way, we go down to our talent materials. So Albedo needs Teachings of Ballad, which is located in Mondstadt. So I would just put Teachings of Ballad. This is going to be the same for every talent, for every character. So you don't, you know, just as long as you know what they need, it's always going to be Teachings of Blank and Guide to Blank, and I think the last one would be Philosophies of Blank. So Teachings of Ballad, Guide to Ballad, Philosophies of Ballad. So Ballad, I'm not gonna, you know, if you're gonna do it all the way up where you want to triple crown your character, it would be Philosophies of Ballad. Take this, add that up here. Let's see how many we need. We need 114, apparently. So we'll just take total needed, 114, add in our 0. Then we would just take our stuff from above us. So the mob boss materials from before, and just fill that in here that like we've already done. And then we would do the same here. I'm not too sure how many is needed for level 90 characters, so I do apologize for that, but we'll just do, let's just say it's 24. So now that we have all of that filled in, another thing I like to do before we move on is I like to add a cover and a icon. So I would do add cover, then I would do change cover, upload file. This is probably going to be blurred out because this is personal stuff of mine. So I would click all files, and I would insert whatever picture I wanted to be as my cover. So I like to make mine a little personalized, but I like to make mine a little attractive looking. So I would click this photo. I should mention that there is a limit on the size of your file. So the limit for a regular account, you know, you hadn't bought the premium, whatever the premium thing is. Again, I'd never used it. This is completely free. You don't really need to buy the premium thing unless you plan on using Notion with like multiple people and stuff like that, as in, I think it's like you're sharing. I don't know what it is. And that just goes to show I don't know what it is. But the maximum file size is 5 MB, so if your photo is over 5 MB, you cannot use it, and you'll have to find another picture that's like a smaller file size, or take that same picture and compress it. So this kind of looks a little weird, so I would click reposition and just drag that. And honestly, this is kind of cute of Albedo's eyes, so we're gonna do that. And then I would just click save position, then I would click add icon, custom, upload file. And the same thing of taking, I like to Google like whatever character I want to use, or what character I'm making the build page out of, and then put, you know, emote after it. And I end up finding very cute emotes that Genshin actually provides through Hoyolab and stuff. So in this case, it's going to be Albedo. So I'm going to click my Albedo one. And there's our little Albedo emote. So now back down, we go to farm. So let's just say I really need to farm Cecilia's. Farm Cecilia's. Scroll down. Now we need to figure out what are artifacts that we need to work on and what our weapon materials are. So we're going to change this from before. So since this is already saying main DPS, just click where it says main, and we're going to change that to sub, because Albedo is going to be our sub DPS. So this is a kind of a little technical, but not, but bear with me. I'm going to press, I think this is a forward slash. Then we're going to click, we're going to type in toggle. Toggle list. And then I'm going to put in, I'm going to control B. Again, if you're on Windows, it's control B. If you're on Mac, I have no clue what that is. Sorry. Then we're going to put, let's just put needed sets, and let me control B that again. Control B just bolts it. Toggle that down. So let's see, we're gonna go back to our game 8 rating, so, and look at what artifact sets that he can use. So it looks like he can use, obviously his number one set is the Husk of Opulent Dreams. And if you don't have a Husk of Opulent Dreams set, what I like to do is I will take their main set, and I also have a stand-in set. So when I'm in the progress of working on getting their main set, I can also just have this as a placeholder until I actually get what I need. So looks like it's best to have a 4-piece set of Defender's Will and a 4-piece set of Husk of Opulent Dreams. So we're going to take that information from what we have. We're going to put Husk of Opulent Dreams first, because that is our priority set, and put 4x because we need a full set of that. And next we would put Defender as well, 4x. So this is our needed sets. Toggle that, and we're going to enter twice. So enter, enter, and then here we're just going to control bold. And this is where we're going to put down what our needed stats are and substats are. So we're just going to put our sands. I believe it's sands. No, I think it's goblet first. Well, whatever. So we're going to do sands, goblet. Make sure you can control bold unless you don't, or control B if you would like that to be bold. And then control B again, circlet. Everybody knows that Albedo works very well with having mostly defense artifacts, but let's go look at it anyway. So Geo sub DPS, he needs defense on his sands, a Geo damage bonus goblet, and a crit rate or crit damage circlet. One thing that you can also look at whenever you're in Genshin, and I think it is called artifact attributes. I can't remember what it is, but there is a little button that's at the very top of where you're looking at each character's artifacts and what's on them, and it tells you what most people build that artifact as. So in this case, probably albedos, and it has a percentage next to it. So let's just say energy recharge, attack percentage, HP percentage, and let's just say energy recharge is the goblet that everybody uses for this particular character. That's just an example. So in this case, we're going to do, just to look back at it, we have defense, geo damage, and crit rate or damage. So here we're going to just put defense percentage, then we're going to put geo damage, and then at the bottom, last for our circlet, is going to be crit rate slash, ignore the slash there, and we're just going to put damage. Obviously it's going to say no results because we have a slash there. So then I'm going to enter again, and we need to see what his priorities for his talents are. So in this case, it's his skill, burst, and the normal attack. So what I'm going to do is we're just going to do elemental skill, elemental burst, and the normal attack. So let's just say I only have enough materials to level up certain things. I would probably focus on these two first because these are the top two priorities versus normal attack. So if I don't want to triple crown the character, but I want the two things that are going to deal me the most damage, it would probably, for albedo in this case, it would be elemental skill and elemental burst. Then we do our weapons. So obviously, let's just say you got albedo on his rerun after cinnabar spindle. So let's just say albedo has a rerun, let's just say albedo has a rerun next month, but obviously cinnabar spindle is not going to be available. I would take the next best weapon that I know that I can have as a free to play. So let's say I want to be free to play and I don't want to make any wishes right now to, you know, get a weapon. So let's just say obviously none of these weapons are available. So what we have is Harbinger of Dawn. That is our next best free to play choice for albedo. So I would right click Harbinger of Dawn, and I would just keep this up as just a reference to add later, because you also can use the impact, Genshin Impact Enhancement Progression Calculator for weapons as well. So we'll just put Harbinger of Dawn. Pull this weapon up. We want our weapon to be up to level 80. So I also do the same for the weapon as well. And we would just take all of these materials right here and copy them over into our Notion. So we're just going to do, we need 6x slime condensate. Then we're going to do 10x slime secretions. And then 4x slime concentrate. And so on and so forth. Alrighty, so we got down all the materials for said weapons. So we have our, these are all mob boss materials, all of this, and then yeah, these are all technically mob boss materials and stuff like that. And then we have our domain materials, stuff that we can only get in domains. Now to kind of finish off this page, we're gonna press enter, that slash again, image, upload file. Obviously this is going to be blurred because this has personal stuff, but we're going to click all files, and then we're going to have our artwork, that Genshin, our character artwork, and we're just gonna put that on the side here. Maybe here. Yeah, there we go. So I like to have this here just because, you know, I just like it being there. And then it is a little bit tricky because sometimes adding like images and stuff can move it. So if it gets moved out of place, I would just select all of this. Actually, I'll select this first, make sure that's under there. Then we're gonna select all of this and set that so it's under there. And then now we have that, and it looks like this. And then we do our toggle. You can see what sets are needed. And then I think that's everything. Oh, lastly, I would copy and paste the links to reference pages. So in this case, it would be Albedo's reference page. So whenever you paste a link, you do dismiss, create bookmark, and create embedded. We want to create a bookmark. So we do create bookmark. It's going to do this. So then when you want to reference back and look at it, all you would do is just click it, and it would open a link to that page. We're going to do the same for Harbinger of Dawn as well. And that is our character page. This is pretty much all I do for, I do it for every single character. There's not a character that does not have it. I would put in a little flower. I like to have this little copy and paste flower, but that's something I would probably do off camera, but you don't have to do that, but I like to do it. So now we have our full character page. So now if you click main build, it takes you back to pretty much all of your builds that you would probably have on here. In this case, it's just Albedo. If you want to move this, you just click reposition and move that so it looks a little better, and then save position. Now, if you're confused and it shows like a bunch of text and stuff like that of what's on the page, make sure you click the three little dots right here. Then you would do layout and make sure that where it says card preview, make sure it says page cover. If it says page content, it's just going to show the content of the page, not the actual cover that you have set up for that page. So make sure it says page cover, or if you don't want it at all, then you could just click none and it'll show like that. But I like to have a little card preview because I think it's cute. Then I would go back here. Obviously, what I like to put up here, I would like to put whatever the name of my thing is. So let's just say this is a like a Funzies Genshin account. Like, I like to have a name of each account. I like to put mine in Korean, so you know, so for example, whether it's blurred or not, it says Swords Only, so that's, I know that that's my Swords Only account, but let's just say this is my Funzies Genshin account. So the next thing I would do, I want this guide to be as extensive as possible because some people might have questions. Next thing I would do is I would put down what character needs what. So in order to do this, to make it simpler, I would simply just right click, copy link, then I would say, okay, I remember that Albedo needs ballad. I would click Control V, and we're going to say mention page, and then it's going to have that page that we just created. So then I would just click that, and it would automatically take me to his character page. So let's go back. For weapons, I don't really do it that much because I don't want to have a separate whole weapons page. I just mainly just do it for characters. So his weapon that we decided that we were going to do is the Boreal's Wolf's Milk Tooth. So we would just put Harbinger Dawn. And now we know that on Wednesdays, we can farm for Albedo's materials, and on Tuesdays we can farm for his weapon, you know. So if you want to keep this all open, and then it looks nice when you have like a plethora of characters, so you know, you can kind of come up with a schedule for what characters to do on what day, etc. So then one other thing I like to do, this can be a little tricky, so just go where this says main team, click that right here, enter, then I will put image, upload file. I will look up whatever character I'm doing and then put icon after it, and then I would just get the provided Genshin icon that, you know, everybody sees that they have available to them, and I would open that. And obviously it's gonna look like this for right now, and it's mainly just because of the fact that if you're only recording one character at the moment, it's only just gonna be that one character, so it's gonna look a little weird. But when you start adding more characters, you can simply just take this and just put it under the character, so it will look more like how on my Swords Only, where it looks like this, so you know, you have each character in a row, kind of like, I mean, your ducks in a row. You can also change this image right here. If you want to change this image to something else, just click the three dots right up there, click replace, upload file, and change the image to something else. Let's just say we want it to be Kaya, since I have a photo of Kaya, and then I would change to a photo of Kaya. So we scroll down, And then one last thing I like to do is actually fill out the master character directory so I can keep tabs on what characters I got on what days. So again, I would click copy link, right click, copy link, under name, control V, mention page. So then I can mention the page. So then when I want to look at the characters page, I can just click on it and it takes me to that page. Click the three dots here and I'll go back to the this right here. Character, I just use that same photo that we used before up there, add that in. Alrighty, so now that's filled in. Put the element that they are, so Geo, they are level 1. We don't have any cons, so I would keep that empty. And then I would say building, yes, in progress. And then obtained, let's just say we obtained Albedo on November 13th, 2023. It's actually not on here, but I'm going to click this plus button right here. And we're just gonna put text. And then we're going to name this one Ascension Level. So what I mean by ascension level is not their actual level, but what, you know, their how many ascension levels we're in. So, you know, where we can level, you know, it's like 20 and then you have to get to rank 15 to level them up to 40, you know, that, etc. So obviously, I think there are like 5 ascension levels, if I'm not mistaken. So I don't want this at the end. I want it to be next to my constellations. So we're going to put that here. And let's say he's already at ascension level 1. So I would Windows button, period, type in a star, and put a star here because he is ascension level 1. We have one of those stars filled in. And then let's just say we got lucky. We got a C1 albedo. Same thing. I would just put a... Actually, I wouldn't put a star. I simply would just put C1. And that's all I would do. And then from that point on, your page is done. If you just want to record just this one character, and then it would be the same thing as if you were adding another character. So one last thing I like to do is, again, I like to personalize mine. So let's just change the cover, upload file. We'll use this picture of the two travelers, the two twins. If you want to move this, just click reposition, drag image. And now it looks like this, and save the position. If we want to add an icon, I just like to use a cute little emoji half the time. So let's just do a little plant and we'll do the cactus, you know, just something random. And then that is basically how I like to put together my Genshin account. You know, it'll start to grow once you get more characters and then you get more comfortable with adding all this stuff. If you have any more questions on how to set all this stuff up, let me know. I will try my best to answer. I'm very bad when it comes to explaining things, but so if there's something you see in this video that still doesn't really make sense to you, you can definitely comment down below and just say, hey, I don't know how you did this, how did you do this, you know, etc, etc. Again, I will be linking down the templates that I made that will be available to all of you guys. Just reminder, you will have to make an account in order to see those templates and save them, and then I forgot how it is if you want to share the templates, like if you want to import the templates from other people. I think it's you just click the template while you're logged into your Notion and then just import to your own page, and then it will, you know, import the page that I've provided to you onto your Notion and stuff like that. But again, Notion is free. You don't have to do any upgrading and stuff if you're just using it for personal use, which again, I use it for a lot of my personal things, writing, Genshin, YouTube, all that good stuff. But now we have our character page together. It's going to come together when you add more characters, you know, when you get more constellations and stuff, and it'll look great because it'll look full, it'll look fleshed out and all that other stuff. It's really fun to do. I really like to do it. So if you enjoyed this video, you know, leave a comment, all that good stuff. If you have any questions, leave them down in the description below, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.